Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. It's Katie here and today is a pretty gloomy Saturday here in Christchurch. While we're not outside, I figured I would pop in front of the camera and give you a little bit of a recap on our recent trip to Nelson over the Easter holidays. We had Friday off and Monday off from work, and so with 4 days, we were like, why not get out of Christchurch, see part of the South Island that we hadn't seen before and just explore, which I'm so glad we did. I was going through the pictures of like everything that we took when we were there to kind of prep for this video, and I was like, oh, it was just so good. It's just so good. So we drove 5 hours to Nelson. On the way there, we did the inland route, and then on the way back, we did the coastal route, which was like 5 hours, 45 minutes-ish. Nelson is such a like quaint, this is how I see it, I guess, like a quaint, cute, small town in New Zealand. Like not obviously the smallest of the smalls, like Fairlie and Geraldine that we've been through are like small, small town, but I think Nelson just seemed like the quaintest place to live. The fall colors are autumn leaves, as everyone calls it here, autumn and not fall. We're just starting to peek through, and as we were driving, the trees and the hills and in the neighborhoods were just so, so beautiful. And then not to mention like the beach is like right there. Everything just seemed so close. So anyways, I thought Nelson was a beautiful place, a really cute city, and somewhere I was like, I can live here. Like easy access to the beach and hills, which we have in Christchurch too. It was just a really cute town. But anyways, first thing, we dropped off our stuff at the Airbnb and kind of like rested for a second after we had been in the car. And first stop was to the beach, which is always my favorite place. It was full of shells everywhere. It was pretty low tide, and so we could walk pretty far out on the sand, and we got right up next to the water, and there were just shells everywhere, and I kept picking them up and being like, oh, this one's cool, this one's cool, this one's cool, I want to take this one. I didn't take any of them because I always feel bad when I take things, I don't know why, like shells from the beach and things like that. I hadn't seen a beach that was just like plastered in shells. It was pretty chilly, so we didn't stay long, unfortunately. On the way back to the car, we saw a Mr. Whippy truck, which, for Americans watching, is an ice cream truck. And one of my coworkers at the gym that I used to work at, one day was talking about Mr. Whippy, and I was like, what on earth are you talking about? And she's like, an ice cream truck. And in America, I guess, at least I don't have a name for like an ice cream truck. Like an ice cream truck is just an ice cream truck. But she was saying that like Mr. Whippy is like the standard ice cream truck. So it was cold, but we both got an ice cream cone because we felt like we had to. So we had our first Mr. Whippy in Nelson. So we got ice cream after going to the beach. And then there was a short like 20 minute walk to the center of New Zealand. It was really gorgeous view, pretty steep to get up there. You would hear people like climbing up around the hill and being like, ah, we're here, we made it, it was worth it. But lots of cool pictures, the beach and then being up high and like on a hill and being able to like overlook a town and the water and everything is like my two favorite places to be, like at sea level. And then the complete opposite, which I feel like maybe a lot of people feel that way. It's just a cool way to see the world. We had a dinner at a small restaurant that night. I wish that I remembered what the restaurant was called, but it was Good Friday. And so most things were closed. So we were very lucky that we found a place that was open. We had the sweetest waitress. This woman was such a gem. We woke up the next morning and drove to Wharariki Beach. And this was something that we had been looking forward to for ages. So if you have a Windows computer, the background of most Windows computers, or sometimes they change, whatever, is Wharariki Beach. And so we were like, we have to go see it. We have to go see it. It was like 2.5 hours from Nelson to drive up there. On the way there, we stopped at the Muscle Inn. One of Keaton's coworkers told him that we had to eat there. So we did, and I had a really good mince pie, and we both had ciders, and it was really good. So if you're ever driving from Nelson to Wharariki Beach, stop at the Muscle Inn, or if you're up near like Collingwood area, that's definitely a place to hit up. But once we got to the parking lot for Wharariki Beach, you walk like 20 minutes in this like gorgeous green pasture. It's private property, so people just, whoever owns it allows you obviously to walk to it to get to the beach. We heard like cows and sheep just hanging out everywhere. You had to watch for poop. And it was funny because you could just see, it's a pretty like thin path in some places, so you could just see like a line of people like walking to the beach. So we finally got to the beach, and you step onto the sand and you're just like beautiful, beautiful white sand, and you see the rock formations, and you're just like, it's a place that you go that you're instantly just like almost like a rush of like peace comes over you because it's just so gorgeous. And as I said, there was a lot of people walking, but it's so big, it's so vast that you don't feel like there's a lot of like tourists or anything like that. So it's not like a crowded place. And you could just see for like miles. We explored for a little bit. We saw a seal that was probably not in the place that he was supposed to be. He was like on one side of the hill, and I feel like he should have been on the other side, but hopefully he found his way back to his family. There was a lot of little kids with pieces of cardboard, and they were like sliding down the sand dunes and running back up and sliding down again. And it was so stinking cute to see them just like living their life, and the parents were just like watching them. And I wouldn't have ever thought to like bring cardboard boxes for them to just slide down, but clearly they had done it before. So after we had explored around a little bit, took tons of pictures in front of what would have been the like signature rock formation, I guess I'll call it. We had taken chairs and books and snacks, and so sat down and read for a little bit on the beach. And it was pretty chilly and pretty windy, and so we were like getting smacked in the face with sand because of where we were sitting. But if the weather had been perfect, I would have stayed there like honestly for the rest of my life because it was just so gorgeous and peaceful. I think that for anyone that comes to New Zealand is like a bucket list destination for sure. Once we had been pelted in the face with sand enough times, Keaton and I were like, okay, it's time to go. It's time to go. So we drove to our Airbnb that was like an hour away from the beach, and it was in the absolute middle of nowhere. I have a video of it here. It was so cute, set up high on this hill, and there were like sleeping quarters and then a separate kitchen, and the shower was attached to that kitchen. And then a little further down there was a compostable toilet, but the view from this place was just amazing. Once again, you could see for miles and miles and miles. And then we were starting to cook dinner that night, and we just like looked out the window, and the sunset was like pink and purple, and the clouds were on our side that night, and just made the most gorgeous, gorgeous ending to a absolutely stunning day. So we of course stayed there that night, woke up in the morning and looked outside, and it was Easter morning, and there were just beams of light coming through the clouds, sunbeams, and it was just so beautiful, and just we sat out there and didn't have any coffee or anything because we didn't plan that well in advance, but just sat out there and enjoyed the view and took it in, and we're just very grateful to wake up there that morning. We packed up and went to an area of Abel Tasman. It was funny because I had told Keaton, like, oh, I want to go to Abel Tasman, like, I just want to see it. I know it's one of the great walks and you have to book huts and things like that, and we didn't want to do that. like stay in a hut or do the whole walk or anything like that, but I just like wanted to see a little bit of it. And it was pretty like sprinkling rain the whole time, but we're like, ah, we don't care, like, let's just go walk it. We stopped at a couple of beaches along the way as well, and I know the water is normally like this like bright blue color, and because of the rain and the clouds, it was a little more dim, but nonetheless beautiful. And it was funny because we were walking for like quite a long time, and I didn't really have an idea in my head of how long I wanted to walk. And then I don't know if Keaton thought I wanted to walk a lot longer. So we didn't communicate very well on that end. But I was like, so how far are we going? He's like, oh, I don't know. How far did you want to go? And I was like, oh, I don't know. Because by this point, we're like very damp from the rain. And we're like, oh, let's just go a little bit further and see what happens. So we keep walking, and then we get to this incline of a hill, like around a corner. And I was like, nope, we're going back. So it ended up being like just 2 hours of a walk. But we got to the hill and I was like, nah, I'm not signing up for that. But Abel Tasman, it was beautiful. Maybe one day we'll do the Great Walk. I think we need to test run camping and things like that first before we do a Great Walk. Abel Tasman, we went and visited Split Apple Rock. Keaton was like, we have to go to Split Apple Rock. We have to go to Split Apple Rock. So we went to Split Apple Rock. We got there, and once again, it's just like a little walk from the street down to the beach area. And Keaton was like, first of all, we got there and there was like no one down on the beach. And we're like, how are we the only ones here right now? And then more people came later, but anyways, down to the beach, and Keaton's like, I'm gonna take off all my clothes and swim out to the rock. I was like, oh heck no, you are not taking off your clothes and swimming down to the rock. So I probably killed his fun a little bit there, but he wanted to like stand in the middle of the rock, like push the rock apart basically. But like I've said in another video, I don't swim too well, and if he was in trouble, don't know what the heck I would do. So I ex-nayed that. But we did find little like coves and caves that were really cool to be in, and that got us even closer to the rock. I probably would have let him swim from there, but he didn't ask, so I didn't bring it up. You could see that people had like private walkways from their house down to that beach, and I was like, oh, this would be the perfect place to live, like overlooking this area and just being able to come down to this beach whenever you wanted, and like not many people are there. It would just be amazing. I'm sure those houses are like millions of dollars. We drove back to Nelson and we were like, well, what do we do? It's Easter and most things are closed, and on Christmas we had actually ordered Indian food because like everything was closed, and we were like, oh, why don't we make it our tradition that on holidays we order Indian food. So we found an Indian restaurant in Nelson, and that was open. And we were like, why don't we just go, like, why don't we just go and sit at the restaurant? And so we were the only people there. There was a couple of people like coming in and out getting pickup orders and things like that. And the waiter was just like standing in the corner because we were the only ones there, just like waiting to see if we needed something. And it was such good food. We got so much food. It was so yummy. We didn't really eat Indian that much when we were in Nebraska. We just hadn't found a restaurant that we liked, but we eat it all the time now. There are so many incredible Indian restaurants in New Zealand, and that's like one of our favorite traditions now. It's like on public holidays, we get Indian food. We were eating and I just started crying because it just sounds pathetic. Seeing such gorgeous things like that whole weekend and then just being at dinner with my husband, eating Indian food on Easter and just being like, this is the greatest. It's just the greatest. And Keaton was like, why are you crying? I'm so happy. So that night, yep, just went back to the Airbnb and settled in and watched a movie and woke up the next morning to drive back to Christchurch, so back on a Monday. And like I said at the beginning, we took the coastal route. So we drove through Kaikoura and had lunch there. And Kaikoura is, again, also such a cute little town to spend more time there. But we got back home and, you know, after like a 4-day weekend, like we had been away from home the 4 days, I was like, I just need one more day to just like rest and recuperate and relax back at home before like heading into work the next day. Of course it doesn't work like that, but wouldn't that be great? But we had such a beautiful time in that 4-day weekend. I highly suggest if you're in New Zealand and in Christchurch and honestly anywhere in the world that you make a trip to Nelson. And we didn't get to see the Marlboro Sounds. We had thought about it and we were thinking like, oh, let's do like a little cruise and get wine and things like that. And the timing just didn't work out. We wanted to try and make it home at a decent time to like feel situated and ready for work the next day. But that is another thing that is on our list. So we need to drive back up there and I'm happy to drive back up there because it was such a gorgeous region of New Zealand that we hadn't seen before. But adding a new like favorite place to the list. So thank you again so much for watching and I'll see you again next time.